I get it. It's the total like, oh, sympathy.
Oh, maybe. Yes. Ellie Payne.
Yes.
You're the funeral queen.
Yeah.
Yeah, you love a good...
I mean, I just go to strangers' funerals because I love watching people cry.
No, explain why I call you the funeral queen. Funeral queen.
I love the dead. Like, I just have a great fascination with death.
And the whole mortuary industry you have a fascination with.
That's part of it, yeah.
If you were invited to an embalming, would you go?
Oh, yes. Mm. Yes.
Mm.
Yeah, like, not and I me. Love it. No?
No.
The smell?
I don't even know if there's a smell. I just don't want to watch all the fluids get drained out.
Or seeing the dead person?
I mean, you see him in the coffin.
Now, I recently was given the opportunity to see some, not just one, some dead people who had like just died. Don't ask me about it. I can't. I know this is a not fair podcast.
Oh my gosh, how do you do
but
that?
I cannot. I just got.
All right, there's a morgue involved somewhere.
I can't tell you.
Well,
so I had the opportunity, and each one that I saw a total of three. Each one that I saw, I was like, oh, okay, whatever. No big deal. You know, one of them was older. So I was like, okay, whatever. Then somebody else was, I think, in his 40s. Mm. Again, I was like, oh, okay. Then I saw one, not very young, but like younger, like 20s.
Oh, wow.
I had a nightmare that night.
Yeah, I can imagine.
It really got to me.
Now, were the bodies somewhat covered or were they just laid out just buck naked?
Oh, no, not naked. It was what they died in.
Oh, you like saw the fresh, the freshness.
What, fresh meat? Like, where were you going?
I didn't want to say fresh kill, but now I did. So, I mean, oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was like really one of the coolest opportunities I've ever had.
I mean, that's a way to put it.
At the same time, I almost regretted it on the last one because of that nightmare.
Now, were they all in one room? Didn't know this was going to develop.
I can't tell you that.
You can't tell me if they were all in one room? Nope. Like, laid out on tables?
Nope, I can't tell you that.
Oh my gosh.
Yep, I can't tell you what the scene was. I can't tell you that's just...
You weren't like actually in a crime scene, were you?
Can't tell you.
Oh my gosh.
Isn't that so great?
No, this is terrible.
It's so great.
No.
So great. And it was just like... Like the older one,
it was quiet.
The older one, especially, I was like, oh, that's totally what I expected.
Okay.
And then because there is a gray tone to their face.
Well, yeah, the blood's no longer pumping through you. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hence,
for
you're
sure.
dead.
Yeah. So it was just, I mean, amazing. And does it pique my curiosity even more? 100%. But I can see why people who work in the funeral home business. Why they have to, unfortunately, get used to it.
Yeah.
Especially with the young ones.
Okay, so I'm going to ask this in a way that you won't have to say I can't tell you.
Okay.
Maybe I asked you already, but there's been so much coming at me with this that I didn't expect.
A great start to the podcast.
I didn't expect this information, or lack thereof, really, is what we're getting.
I know, I'm sorry.
Were they embalmed yet?
No.
Oh. Wow.
I know.
Oh my God. You were totally at a crime scene. Totally.
No, I mean, oh no, I can't.
Okay. Don't.
I can't say anything else.
I don't want to mess up your next opportunity to go into the next crime scene. So.
Or maybe the next funeral home.
Mm-hmm. I was going to think you were somehow in the morgue of a hospital. That's what, which, you know.
Possibly. I mean, if you think about it, we have connections in so many different fields that have to do with dead people, whether it is we know a funeral director very well.
That's true.
We know
Waltz organizes parades.
Yeah, we know hospital people
true.
Really well.
Yeah.
And yeah, that opportunity.
We know a lot of cops.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm going to just really quickly adjust your camera. Don't worry.
Okay, I'll be right here. Did it move?
It moved.
It moved. What, you just get in my head?
Okay.
All right. So now that you took us there,
yeah.
I was going to ask you, would you expect a guy to bring a condom to a funeral?
Who are
Talk
you
about a stiff
Who
one.
Are you banging? Are you banging?
Don't say it.
The dead? Yes. No, no, I'm serious. No. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay. I get it. It's the total like, oh, sympathy.
Maybe. Yes.
I know somebody who had, speaking of sympathy, Fox, I know somebody who had sex, I can't believe this, in a hospital while his mother was dying.
Oh, wow.
Yes. So what happened was,
I felt bad when I was banging Tracy years ago and my granny was dying. But I wasn't
Tell me that story.
I wasn't in the nursing home, though. That certainly didn't happen.
Well, tell me that story.
Huh?
Tell me that story.
Well, that was it. I mean,
Your grandma was in hospice. She was
No, she was in a nursing home. And I mean, what do? You wait around? I mean, I didn't wait around. My mom was there and, you know.
So your mom was waiting for you.
My mom was waiting for her mom to die.
Yes.
I was, you know, doing something different.
Doing Tracy.
I was doing Tracy.
Now, where were you and Tracy?
At Tracy's house.
Okay. So it wasn't
in the nursing home cafeteria.
Well, or your grandmother's house.
Oh my God, no.
That was the other thing. Okay, back to the guy.
Yes.
So what happened was his mom was in the hospital. She was dying, whatever. Like, I can't remember what happened. Because the story is like, it's not fresh in my mind. It's been years since I've heard it. So, but I do remember that his mom was in the hospital dying and him and his girlfriend went into like a side room that no one was using.
Oh my gosh.
I could not. I would be so sad. Again, yeah. The funeral thing too. I'd be stricken with grief, even though paying family funerals are super fun. I know that sounds really weird, but we get together, we laugh, we have a good time, we tell lots of great memories.
That's a good way to go.
Yes. I'm not to the point where I'm like, I'm so sad, I need somebody to give me sympathy, and then I'm going to bang
sympathy
you.
Sympathy sex, yeah. Yes. Exactly. No, the reason I say that is there's this new study that revealed 80% of men have shown up at a funeral home with condom in hand, or in wallet, not in hand per se. And I couldn't believe that I read this. This was a survey from Trojan.
Yeah.
And I mean, it sounds weird. However, believe it or not, some believe that grief can activate one's libido.
Ew. Now, have you ever gone to a funeral home with a condom in your wallet or whatever?
No, I don't carry a condom anywhere.
I mean, okay, but like when you were a younger guy, though.
No, I never did. And I went through a series of a lot of deaths. Although,
that's right. Your mom died and then your dad died, right?
No, it was in the series of deaths, it was, let's see, first my dad, then my grandmother, which was his mom, then my Aunt Marion. Oh, gosh, there was a while there. Then there was a break, and then my niece passed away.
And of course, who were you with at the time? Tell me the relationship. We can give her a fake name. Why don't we call her?
When my mom and dad, when my dad died, I was with nobody. I was actually alone at that point.
Okay.
When my mom died, there was someone. I'll leave them nameless. But I never thought like, oh, let's go do it. My mom died. That ripped it out of me. You know, like it was my mom.
Right.
I think here's my thought on this.
Grandparents.
This can happen if you're like friends of the family or, you know, you're a distant cousin. I'm not saying cousins doing cousins. I'm saying like, let's say you go to the funeral because you know the family and there's a cousin there. That might, not your cousin, but one.
I like how you keep saying, not your cousin. Your cousin.
We're not bringing family, you know, closer at a funeral, if you know what I mean. But I'm thinking like, okay, I knew the whole family, right? Uh-huh. And here's a great example. So let's say I went to my buddy Brad's funeral, which I did.
Yes.
Now, I never looked around the room and thought to myself, that one right there, she's the one.
Who's ripe for the picking.
Right, exactly. But apparently it can activate one's libido, and I had no idea. Now, let me ask. Okay, I'm going to switch this back to you. You have a fascination with death.
Yeah.
Have you gone home afterwards and said, Zach, you and I need a few minutes?
No, I don't think it's so much that it like, it's not that it, okay, I think it could be one of two things. Either you're really appreciating life and going, life is short, so let's.
But this isn't.
so let's live, you know, you want to do like make the most of it. I think there is the sympathy sex.
Okay.
And I think the sympathy sex is more from women than men, but maybe that's because I'm a woman saying that. Like I've definitely been horned up.
Yes.
After you feeling sad, it's like I need to switch, flip the script.
Okay.
My emotions are, I've been so far down here, I need to bring myself up.
And that's what popped into your head instead of a comedy show.
It's also, I think for females, it's because at least like I know that I'm a very nurturing person. Shocker. But I know that I'm a nurturing person.
So cuddle me naked?
Well, yeah. Like, so I want to nurture you at your lowest point. Oh my God, that sounds so weird.
Wow. I really must be ugly because when my mom died and I was a mess, nobody came to me and said, hey, let's go.
And you were with somebody.
You know what? You're right. I was with somebody at that point in time. But now that I think about it,
none of
my ex-girlfriends that, you know, from Buffalo, when my mom or dad died, showed up at the funerals.
What?
Well,
oh, no, your ex-girlfriends.
Ex-girlfriends.
Oh.
But think about this, though.
That's a tough spot to be in.
Yeah, you know, it is. Because, and not that I'm thinking about it. That would have been weird because... What are they going to do? Show up and then again, at that time, who was reading a newspaper for obituaries besides grandma who was actually telling her friends, you know? So you get the demographic that was showing up at the funeral.
Well, I think with that too, it depends. How did your relationship end? What was your relationship?
You know me. Every relationship ends for me way up here. I mean, they all just end. Everybody loves me after it's over. I mean, you know that.
Yeah,
you know how true that is.
Yeah,
I mean,
100%.
Something ends, man, it's like we're still together.
So here's...
Bullshit.
with me, I am still friends with lots of my exes to a certain degree.
Mm-hmm.
I think that over, especially the past 4 years, so I'm with someone... And who I plan on marrying. I'm going to be with this person the rest of my life. And it was with him that I really started to disassociate with exes because I hung out with exes sometimes.
Yeah.
And then when I got with him, he was like, but why? Like, what's the purpose of that?
Well, if it was a really short-term ex, I could see because you would have realized you were friends much quicker than you realized you should have been together. That I can understand. But if there was a length of time of dating, I get his point.
But I think that the reason why they didn't show up, part of it is not only their feelings about you, but also to not disrespect the current person you're with. And maybe they didn't know you were with somebody or they didn't know the status and they don't want to make...
And their lives move on.
Exactly. Yeah. And I think that's exactly why my significant other is like, why are you still talking to exes and hanging on to exes? Like, we've moved on. And now I literally have, if I see exes somewhere, I saw one... in February, and we laughed, we had a good chuckle, we had a good conversation, but I haven't thought about him since. I've completely moved on. There's never this like, oh, I wonder what he's doing.
Right.
So I think that's the other thing too, is out of respect for you and the person you're with, that they didn't show up.
I guess
up.
I hadn't thought about it like that. I mean, of course, all my friends were there and everything. And
of course.
And some of them were female and all that, but you know,
That's the other thing. They probably thought he's got enough support. You had a great support system.
Yeah, what am I going to do? You know, I mean, and they moved on with their own lives. They may have had things happening. Mm-hmm. They may not have ever known, you know, it's very likely.
Now, if they did show up, I could see them being like, oh, got to get that bang in.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, you got one of those Trojans on you from the survey? Let's go.
You got one left in you?
No, I'm going to leave one in you though. Oh, look at that. All right. I did not know that till today about the libido. I had no idea. Now, I know you have a couple things, but I definitely have one thing before the end of the podcast. We're gonna name something after you.
Okay,
but and you get to choose.
All right, we'll come back with that, and then we'll also come back with, have you ever heard of the phrase getting noping out of a relationship?
Noping? No. Well, maybe I have with what we just talked about a minute ago. We'll be back with that in a minute.
I don't know if you know this or not, but Junior, my Shih Tzu Lasso Apso, he's a rescue. And that's why I love and believe wholeheartedly in the Chemung County SPCA. There's just so much love to give. There's so many doggies and kitties who need a good home. But did you know the Chemung County SPCA does way more than that? They do spay and neuter clinics, vaccination clinics. They even have a pet food pantry. What this is say, for instance, you get a little down and out on your luck and you don't have enough money to feed your dog or cat. You can go to them and they will give you puppy or kitty food. I should say dog or cat food. And they will give you some food and some treats to get you through. It's equal love. That's what it is. The other thing that's great is we as a community are always so helpful with each other. Sometimes there's things that the SPCA needs. It might be bleach or blankets or washcloths. Follow them on social, Chemung County SPCA, because there might be something that you can give, because you never know. It might need to come back to you. Either which way, follow them on social. And next time you need a dog or cat because you need some extra love in your life, well, hit up the Chemung County SPCA. Usually I say no pain, no gain, but not in this case. Oh my gosh, my booty was hurting. I have been talking about this for months. My sciatic nerve has just been on fire and I couldn't figure out, well, how do I fix this? And that's when I discovered Horseheads Acupuncture and decided I'm going to give it a try. I didn't even feel the needles whatsoever. Now, you might not have sciatic issues, but if you have muscle pain, anxiety, even depression, acupuncture can treat all of that. If this is speaking to you and you want to give acupuncture a try, then text the word ACU, A-C-U, you to the number you know so well, 71231, to see how you can get a discount on your first treatment, whether it's acupuncture, cupping, or massage. Robert from Horseheads Acupuncture spent about 2 hours with me, not only going over my treatment, cupping, and massage. He was ready to get to the root of the problem. If that's how you are feeling right now, you just want to get to the root of the problem, then try Horseheads Acupuncture right in Hanover Square and text the word ACU, A-C-U, to 71231. Okay, let me explain what noping out of a relationship is. This is when you first start dating somebody, Scott, that they do something before the relationship really becomes a relationship and you nope them out. You're like, nope, not gonna continue with that. And I have a great story.
Okay.
So one time I was dating a guy and things were going decently. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't like fireworks. Oh my God, this is the person I'm gonna marry, whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And we were at a bar together, a female that he knew. I don't know, friend. I'm not exactly sure how their relationship was, but a female that he knew came up to him and was talking to him and was standing in between his legs. So he was sitting at a bar stool.
Oh.
And this pissed me off.
Yeah, that's a nope.
So but it didn't even end there. That's what should have noped it out of the relationship, right?
Right.
No, I'm too freaking forgiving. So anyway, so I didn't get like mad. I wasn't like, you motherfucker.
You know? I would have walked up to that and have been like, and you are?
I ignored him. I went outside, talked to one of my girlfriends, and then basically kind of gave him the cold shoulder. So here's where I noped him right out. He was like, I didn't do anything wrong. She was like, came to talk to me. She was the one that stood in between my legs. Once I heard that justification, I was like, nope. I am noping you out of this relationship right now. And it did not last another day after that.
Now,
I was like, that's the biggest bullshit I've ever heard.
As a guy, I will tell you, and his excuse was terrible, by the way, you know, the justification for it. Well, there is no justification for it. The problem is, guys are built, we're all built one way. And that was called attention onto us. She's standing, and that's, it's a kind of sexy move. I'm not going to lie. Standing right in between your legs like that, you know, because you think how you sit on a bar stool.
Yes.
That's a move.
He should have, at the time, knowing that we were there together, we were hanging out, we were in the beginning of a relationship, he should have moved her away or just stood up.
Beginning of a relationship. You know what he was doing?
What?
He was keeping the attention, or he was keeping it where if it didn't work out with you, he had a girl that was between his legs.
Ew.
That's not a joke. That's real.
But he obviously wasn't into me enough then, is what I think.
Well, I think it may not have been that per se. Maybe it could have gotten there. But I think what he was thinking was, if this doesn't go somewhere, I still got something.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you did the right thing on that one. I mean, that was because if he was very much into you and really thought confidently this is going to go somewhere, he'd have done the old reposition and been like, oh, excuse me, you know, and whatever. And it wouldn't have been kind of an awkward look. Sorry, I just sat on my balls.
Or he would have, like I said, stood up, ended the conversation, stood up, and then came to me.
Oh, basically, standing up, that's another great one, because, you know, you immediately get into a position where no longer is she between your legs. Yes.
Exactly.
I agree with you so much on that one.
And I think that if he would have came and talked to me, and I like this move, it is him marking his territory, peeing on the tree. I am a
If he came and peed on you while you were at a table.
I am a big fan of marking territory, peeing on trees. Zach, I think, can't stand this sometimes. We will be in a situation, it might even be the grocery store, a picnic, a whatever, and I will go over, I'll hold his hand, I will do something to indicate I own this.
Okay.
And he'll even say to me, and he loves pointing it out. He's like, quit peeing on that tree.
That's awesome.
Like, no, you're mine. I'm making it known with a small, tiny gesture.
You know, I want you to think about this, too. What if it was reversed? I mean, you know, if the guy went up to the girl and they were, I mean, I would be very put off by this. If it was,
are you talking about the barstool situation?
Well, or, similar enough
or
to that.
Peeing on the tree.
The peeing on the tree, I mean, that's a to each his own. It depends on the situation where you have to pee on the tree. You know, I mean, that's, sometimes you need a good long piss on that tree. Other times, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
It's situational. No, but I was thinking about this because you had said the girl had done this,
mm-hmm.
Which, by the way, also the girl obviously must have known. Well, she must have looked at you and thought, oh, I got her beat.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you.
Probably.
Trash bag. So if it was the other way around, though, equally put off. Like, you know, if you... Or not you, but if I got up and went and did that, I would expect you to be like, what the hell did you just do?
Exactly. I would never do this in a relationship.
I agree.
And that's why I just knew it wasn't going to last, because you disrespected me.
Yep.
From the first couple weeks.
Got noped right out.
Yes.
Yeah.
And by the way, with my little tantrum that I threw, which all it was like ignoring, he even tried to call me on that and was like, oh, you know, the way you behaved. The way I behaved.
Nope. This guy right here.
Excuse me.
I can tell you, it's a damn good thing you didn't stick around, because when a guy does that and mm-hmm. tries to spin it out to the girl as being the problem,
yes.
when he easily could have gotten himself out of that situation at that moment, but did not want to.
Mm-hmm.
Scumbag.
Oh, I like that.
Scumbag. Let me ask you a question.
I like that passion.
That's what it is. So when you come home drunk from a girl's night out, do you climb into bed with your significant other or go to another room or the couch?
Of course I'm climbing in bed.
Oh, God.
Because, again, I'm a very touchy-feely person.
Now, I've been out for 2 hours. Don't touch me with your drunk hands.
I know this annoys Zach so much.
He's sound asleep.
He's sound asleep, and he's like, oh my God, you reek like a bottle of wine. Like, get away from me.
You reek.
Yeah.
Like, what a turn on.
Yeah. Okay, but I'm going to give you the equivalent of something then.
Okay.
If we're going to go down this path, because yes, I'm getting in bed and I'm disrupting your sleep. And then I'm like, let me tell you about the fight between Sonya and James.
Please go to the couch.
Yeah. Oh, he hates it. But, what was my comparison? Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. So my comparison is, what if I'm sound asleep, me, and you try to wake me up for a little poon in the middle of the night? I used to love this move.
Now you just want sleep.
Yes, I'm like, leave me alone.
You know, maybe I'm wrong on this. Doesn't the wake you up for poon happen really early in a relationship? I mean, at some point you guys start realizing, you know, sleep's great. We can bang later.
Without giving away too much of my personal life on the air, in the podcast, I should say, it doesn't always go away. Sometimes the mood just strikes you.
It does. It does. But it's more common earlier on.
It's more common early on. And that's why later on in the relationship, I just want sleep.
Let me tell you what I would want, not what I would do. What I would want, you to go to one of the other rooms and just sleep it off,
mm-hmm.
have your night. Let me sleep.
No,
because you had a girl's night out. I'm going to have to wake up and do stuff in the morning, and you're not getting up real early. So.
I know I'm not. And I know that also when I get a bottle of rosé in, I get a little handsy. So
Zach knows too.
So that's the problem.
Yeah.
Is that not only do I need to talk about this, I'm putting my booze breath in your mouth.
Jeez.
And then
I should have added one more. Spend the night at your friend's house so I can sleep.
I should. This is so, I mean, hopefully we get a house soon. And I feel like him and I definitely need to create some house rules. And this might be one of the house rules. Because I even said to him, we had a great conversation
the
other day.
A great question when you're done. Go ahead.
Okay. I even said to him, first of all, if we get this house that we want, there is a spare bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to him, hey, you know, my girlfriends just randomly stop over, and not all the time, but they do, or we'll have a girls' night. So I said, this house needs to be set up where we can have our girls' conversations and you can be playing video games or whatever you, mm-hmm. whatever you want to do. I don't care. Watching a movie. And it makes me think besides us setting up that those boundaries on like when girls come over, how long they stay, when they come over, because I feel like there has to be a setup. They can't just like pop in like they do at my house.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Yeah. It has to change a bit.
It does. I think there
you're going to have to send a text first and you're going to have to tell Zach they're coming.
Right. Right. Exactly. But I think that maybe this will be one of our new house rules too, is if I have a girls' night at my house, I'm automatically sleeping in the spare bedroom.
Very good move, because he's going to be annoyed because all he hears is a lot of clucking in the other room.
Yeah.
And, you know, the hens are in there plucking away.
Yeah.
But
clucking and clucking.
Yeah, right. Exactly. But the last thing he wants is any fucking after the clucking. So I just thought of a quick question that hit me as you were describing this. And we have to do the naming of something.
Oh,
so,
yeah. I forgot about that.
I want you to be honest now. Now, okay. You're a bit of a bossy person.
Uh-huh. Bossy bitch.
Right. You like it the way you like it. I get it.
Right, right.
Zach also has, he has things the way he likes them.
Yes. You have to think, we've been so independent for so long.
Who is going to make the first house rule? And do you think you know what it might be when you guys buy the house and move in together?
I think we've already started talking about it.
Oh, the house rule? Like, one of you two is going to come up with the first rule in the house.
Well, that's the thing. We already started talking about it with the girls' nights. So it's
going to be the one?
Well, I mean, that's a big one for me because I'm such a social person.
Okay.
What other rules would you like?
Between the two of you, you don't think there's going to be a list on the refrigerator of the rules?
Oh, yes. One of them, which this is, it's something I've been trying to implement for the longest time, but Zach hates.
She's going
to
be first.
Is peeing with the door open. Like, I want to pee with the door open.
And he doesn't want
that.
Now, if he puts, I think, this is what I think you should do.
Is this going to be a game?
Well, you're going to turn it into that. I think when you move in, you put on each side of the fridge,
mm-hmm.
Allie's rules, Zach rules. And it's that white Sharpie stuff where you can write it in.
Yeah.
See who writes first, pee with the door open or closed.
Ooh, I love this idea.
Because whoever puts it in first.
Yes.
They get to have the rule.
I love this too, because there should be, you know, this is not something that bothers me. This is something that bothers him.
Right.
I am the queen of leaving like a quarter cup of a drink around.
Yes.
And he calls them my bots, like my bottles, you know, because I have to have like my Diet Coke, my water, my sparkling, blah, blah, blah. And so he's like, you have three cups around, like pick them up. I'm like, I'm still drinking out of them.
Oh, yeah. As you pass by them 3 days later. Yeah.
So I think he'll be the first one to make the house rule. And I think that's going to be the rule.
Why don't you suggest my idea? We'll put whiteboards up on either side. House rules. Zach, Allie, whoever gets to write it first and they put the date on it, they get the rule.
I like that. I will suggest it, but I'm also going to put it on social once it happens. So, cross your fingers. We'll find out today on the house.
Oh, that's exciting.
Okay, what's the naming thing?
Okay, so if you could have one of the following things named after you, because they name a lot of things after people, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Here's your choices. Are you ready?
Yes.
A school. Like as in an elementary or a middle school or a high school, a college, more like a university, an airport, a skyscraper, a sports franchise, a stadium, a band, the Allie Paynes, bunch of screamers, an incredible invention, a plane or a race car. I'm going to take the plane and the race car off mine. I don't care anything about that.
Okay. I already got mine.
What is yours?
Mine's going to be airport.
Okay.
First of all, not school or college, because usually that's people who are prestigious and who've done something great in their life.
Not us.
Not me.
Not us.
I think because I'm such a traveler and have gone to so many different places and love the idea of traveling, that I think Allie Payne Airport sounds amazing.
The Payne Port.
The Payne Port.
The Payne Port.
Yes. But I got to also come up with like, fly the friendly skies or hold on a second.
You don't need a slogan. You just need your name out. Oh,
yeah,
okay.
I do.
She needs a slogan.
I do.
All right.
Hold on 1 second. Oh my God. Okay. Ah, so excited. Okay. So Allie Payne.
I thought we'd make it through one podcast without that.
Okay. The airport's going to be here.
Yeah.
Here in the Finger Lakes.
Okay.
So Allie Payne Airport, from the Finger Lakes to your fantasy.
It's a great slogan.
Yes!
That is a great slogan. Applause. Okay.
Well, okay, what are you picking?
Mine's the skyscraper. Well, I jokingly call my house Stately Free Manor.
Yes.
You know, like Batman has Wayne Manor. So I jokingly call it Stately Free Manor.
Yeah.
But a skyscraper and a big one. And I already came up with the slogan.
See, and you were getting on me about the slogan?
Scott's Towers, take the ride to the top.
I love it.
Isn't it great?
That is so great.
It is great. Yes.
I thought you were going to say sports team.
Well, I mean, I know it's a bit neurotic, you know, because maybe not neurotic, maybe a bit narcissistic because you got like, you think like Trump Towers.
Yeah.
But mine, people wouldn't be taking a picture in front of it with their middle fingers up. You know what I mean?
What's going to be in your skyscraper?
Oh, we'd have offices on some levels, okay. And I'm sure apartments. I would definitely have the penthouse. That's there. Take 100%. The ride to the top.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
You know, I mean, I think it's cool. It'd be really cool to have but I don't want like a nub building, like four stories. I want like, it's got to be like a 40-story skyscraper or better.
I think you should also have a restaurant and a bar that's like all the way around.
That'd be awesome at the top, like with a panoramic view of wherever this building is.
When you go to Chicago, depending on the building, like the Sears Tower.
The old Sears Tower, yeah.
Has the Cheesecake Factory. I think. I don't know. I haven't been there in some years. But they have the Cheesecake Factory down below. And that's okay.
Yeah.
But I'd rather be, me personally, in a restaurant that was towards the top.
You ever been in one of those restaurants at the top that rotates real slow?
That's what I'm saying. That's what you need to have. Something like that.
I was at one of those once in Vancouver, British Columbia.
Yeah.
This was one of the trips where my parents and I, we went cross country by car.
Mm-hmm.
In a car with no air conditioning, and it was a two-door. I mean, it was whatever. It was 1980. But we're at the top. This is a really cool just ender because it's like one of those almost brushes with fame.
Yeah.
So we're at the top, and, you know, the restaurants move really slow, mm-hmm. and you're looking down. And on one of the circle passes through, I look down at this big boat, and I'm like, man, it looks familiar. And we went around again, and I go, I think that's the Love Boat.
Love Boat.
It really was a no joke. And I had everybody convinced at the table. Now, mind you, it was my mom and dad, his grown relatives, you know, cousins or whatever that he hadn't seen in years, but they lived there. And I go to my guys, is that the Love Boat? And it docked down there. And they go, yeah, I think it actually might be. We can go down and check it out because it actually docked in Vancouver. Now, the old original Love Boat, way back in the day, it was the Pacific Princess. So if you remember the old TV show, Captain Steubing and all that from the 80s, we literally walked right up to the Love Boat. We couldn't get on the Love Boat, but we walked right up to it. And I saw it from one of those restaurants that was way up top.
Awesome. All right, say your tower name again. Scott's Tower?
No. Did I name my tower?
I don't know. For some reason, I thought you had the...
Stately Free Manor, was it Scott's Skyscraper, Take a Ride to the Top?
Okay, you had the
slogan. The slogan was good.
It is fantastic.
Scott's Towers, Free Towers.
Free Towers.
Free Towers, Free Towers.
Take a Ride to the Top.
That's right.
Allie Payne Airport, from the Finger Lakes to your fantasy.